Vigyan Samagam, a major science exhibition by India, depicting seven of the mega science projects where India is participating. I have with me Dr. K. VijayRaghavan, the principal scientific advisor to the government of India. Dr. VijayRaghavan, a poor country like India, why should we invest in these mega science projects?
You know, if you look at the world as it's going to be in 2050, if you look at the world today and compare it with 30 years ago, India is both going to be the world leader in economic terms, and today is also a dramatically growing country. And the only reason that India is where it is because of its investment in education, in science, in technology, coupled with a deep commitment to its people. A commitment to people without science and technology is no use, and a commitment with science and technology without a link to people is no use. India is unique amongst post-colonial countries to have this link, and therefore can not only transform itself, but can transform the planet.
But why so much money? Can't we do small science? Can't we do, Prime Minister Narendra Modi says, go out and help people. How do these mega science projects help the Aam Aadmi?
They help in two ways. If you look at what the Indian Space Research Organization has done, that is a mega science project which there were severe critics in the early days saying, aap bekar mein rocket upar dal rahe hain, usme hamare desh ka kya hoga? Today, ISRO has transformed the country. If you look at in terms of the geospatial understanding we have of our country, along with, you know, the Ministry of Environment and Sciences, our ability to predict weather changes, climate changes, and warn people is absolutely amazing. Our ability to have high-resolution data of property, of landslides, of disasters is absolutely terrific. Similarly, there are other situations. You look at the Department of Atomic Energy. The Department of Atomic Energy is not just looking at esoteric atomic energy, but its nuclear power plants is transforming the country. You know, so these are not aspects which is an either-or. We must invest in small science hugely. We must invest in, you know, learning hugely. We must have equal opportunity and democracy in science for everyone. But it's not an either-or situation. India is not Liechtenstein where it can say we won't do these kinds of things. We have to do that.
You believe there is a secret weapon which India has which can unleash its power? Tell me a little bit about that secret weapon.
Well, the secret weapon which we have been talking about for some time is half our population, women. Women are extraordinary. They have, you know, come into our education and research base in a huge way. You go to small colleges, you go to medical colleges, you go to engineering colleges all over the country, you see an increase in women. They need to be more in engineering and STEM streams a lot more. But more fundamentally, women need to be in leadership positions all over the country. And if we make that change proactively and consciously, we are unleashing the secret weapon. We are getting half our population into quality science, technology, society, law, commerce, business on scale. And this is something which, you know, is the dark fiber in our network which has to be lit up. And that can be lit up very rapidly.
So the known unknown?
Well, the known unknowns, we are many things which we don't know things about which we can address. For example, let's take how diseases come and how they spread. As Indians, we have a strong mathematical tradition, a strong tradition in statistics, but we have barely few mathematical modelers of disease spread in our context. Now, if we can do that, that would be really transformative for our health system. Similarly, modeling our traffic systems, modeling our weather systems. So I think bringing in mathematics and statistics to the real world is something which we can do rapidly and have an enormous impact.
So it's worth investing in these mega science where we are putting in billions of dollars literally?
We are putting in actually much less because together with the rest of the world we are putting in billions of dollars, right? So it's not that we are putting it. I would add that there are other kinds of big science which Indians must take the initiative. These are all extraordinarily, you know, inspiring mega projects all over the world. India is now has stood up and should develop its mega projects. And its mega projects should come from its context. And there are many things such as, you know, having access to anything, all learning in any language. That's a fantastic mega project. A global biodiversity project, which is led by India, is a mega project. a global science and technology for electric mobility and transportation in difficult contexts is an Indian mega project. Climate change in terms of our oceans, modeling that and implementing it is an Indian mega project. So these are exciting things which I urge our scientists to work with our government to push.
So is the government helping you in these?
The government is very enthusiastic and most proactive, and I think science and technology like defense and foreign affairs is something which all of us work together, and this is something which, you know, we need a bottom-up and a top-down partnership of scale.
So that was Dr. K. VijayRaghavan, the principal scientific advisor to the government of India, telling us that investing in these mega science projects is only going to help India in the long run. In Mumbai, Pallava, Bagla.